What is happening, y'all? Today's dirt series, detailing in real time series, we're gonna do a little bit of wash bucket prep. That way y'all can see exactly what I do whenever I'm prepping my wash buckets for a wash. See if I can angle this camera out just a touch. So I use the two bucket method for washing. I think most people are going to use the two bucket method. There's one bucket method. There's cars that are destroyed method, you know, that you really can't hurt. You just want to get clean so you can get corrected. But this is the claim it. Just leave that up there. But the water needs to be changed out. So rule of thumb, this is the wash mitt. It just kind of lives in here because I don't have a real place for it. This absolutely cannot hit the ground, so I usually take the grit guard and set that up there. That way it doesn't hit the ground. If it does hit the ground, it's fine. I have extras. I can always just put another one in there, but or just go get a new one. So grit guards come out. This is the towel. It's a shitty towel. It lives in between my two buckets. This just needs to get a little bit wet and can go right back to its home. And then we can take these buckets out and dump them. So if y'all can see this, there's some pretty gnarly stuff that comes out of here. This is my soap bucket. It's not terribly bad. This right here is my rinse bucket. It's gonna be the worst of the two, but you do this often enough, it's really not that terrible. But you can see like some of the junk that comes out of here. So the reason why I got this towel moist is so I can just kind of wipe out the inside of this real quickly and then wipe out the inside of that one, which needs more help. And then what I'll do is I'll put that right back there and we'll go over here to the water and we'll just put a little bit of water in here. Yes, my lead hose for filling up buckets is too short. It shut up. Just a little bit of water in here. The water turned back off. Now I can just finish the clean out here. So that's it for that one, and the really heavy, dirty one. Oop, this is a little heavier. Oh God! That's it for that one. We are good to go to get these filled up. And if y'all are asking, if y'all can see that, there's some dirt in the bottom of that. No. It's stuck in the cart or in the dolly. I really don't care. That's never gonna make it back onto the car, so it's not a thing that I really pay attention to unless I want to clean the bucket dolly. So I'll get these two guys filled up. I actually put the water in the bucket, not into the middle. Yeah, I know this part is super exciting, right? But I told y'all, we're gonna go through this stuff in real time. You're gonna see prep. You're gonna see various issues I have with some of these cars. You're gonna see how to wash some of these cars in various stages of dirty and clean. Yeah, just wait until I make a video of a car that is relatively clean on how to clean a clean car. The dirty ones are fun. The cleaning a clean car it sounds kind of dumb, but you're still improving. So we can get these guys filled up. All the excitement. These are 5 gallon, 6 gallon buckets. These are filled up. Now we have a crucial step, since I'm not necessarily washing out the wash mitt. So we're going to put the grit guards back in. This one goes into the soap bucket. And then this one right here goes into the rinse bucket that's been holding the wash mitt. And you squeeze this out as much as you can. It doesn't have to be perfect or anything. It's still just a mitt. So this does not go into your soap bucket. This goes into your rinse bucket. This is the dirtier bucket. For the first time, it sits in here. And then once you start washing, you can swish it around and get it cleaned off, so everything kind of settles under the underneath the grit guard, and then you can go into the soap bucket and onto the car for the first time. Just a general rule of thumb. Does it really matter? I don't know. It might, but it's helped me in the past. It's a good rule to have. And y'all, that is it. This is how you prep buckets. Water is mostly clear. Mitt is ready to go, and you put whatever soap you're using, just a couple ounces in that bucket. Use a foam can if you have one to put soap in the bucket. That part really doesn't matter. But that's it. Y'all make sure you like and subscribe. We will go over a ton more stuff coming up in the future. But hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Junction Auto out.